Hey guys, Captain Henson here. So in today's video, I'll be talking about the third and final part of the Darth Bane trilogy, Dynasty of Evil. So, as everyone should be well aware, I was not a particular fan of the first two books. Mostly due to the absolute shitshow that was the continuity errors between or with the other Darth Bane stories, those being Jedi vs. Sith and Bane of the Sith. But going into this one, I knew that this was its own original story, not trying to adapt any another story. So, in that regard, this is probably, I don't know if that's my favorite. It certainly didn't piss me off like the other two did. And it's on a much smaller scale than even the second book, which was on a much smaller scale than the first. But I think in this case, it does work. Because this is the end of the trilogy, this isn't a spoiler, but we see the end of Darth Bane. And, like the last book, Bane and Zanna are apart for most of it, so, again, not a fan of that. I would have loved to have seen more story or stories with them together, but, oh well. Well, at least the stuff we do get with Bane and Zanna is interesting. Bane at this point is, well, getting older, starting to feel tremors in his hand. And he's looking for a holocron from Darth Dendu to learn essence transfer. And that should sound familiar because it's what Palpatine would use in Dark Empire centuries later. And Zanna, meanwhile, is gearing up to finally fight Bane. But the conflict is, Bane is afraid that Zanna is content with where she is, as just being an apprentice. And of course, he's worried that if she finds out about his, well, tremors and his degrading body, she'll kill him and But killing him when he's in a weaker state means that she's not really strong. She hasn't proved herself to become the master. And Malzana, meanwhile, notices that his body's degrading, you know, tremors. But she's thinking that it's actually an act, that he's trying to trick her. And while all that's going on, Zanna is trying to find an apprentice. And we get the return of Caleb's daughter, Sarah, who, in the last book we were told, had gone away to another location. So in that regard, this story does act as a conclusion. I mean, yes, we do see the death of Bane. But also with the Jedi versus Sith stuff. I said in regards to the last book, Rule of Two, that book seemed to tie up like every loose end from the Battle of Rusan, and it did. And in here the stuff we get with Sarah is more so a new story, but it does continue what we got with the last time we saw her and the last time she was mentioned. Here she wants to get revenge against Darth Bane. She's having nightmares about him and at some point finds out that, you know, her father died. So, yeah, in terms of this story is far more character driven than the other two. And honestly, I think that it was for the best. Because, yeah, at this point, we don't need another story where the Jedi think the Sith are dead. Again. And the story didn't need to be this larger than life thing. It's very low key. And the battle between Bane and Zana is really good. And certainly something that made me happy while reading this book was there are far more female characters than there are male characters. Putting aside, and when it comes to my preferences, I think female characters are more appealing than male characters. And when you, and of course, you know, when you read stories based on franchise, or I just like seeing more female characters. So if we have a franchise that has like a far more abundance of male characters than female characters, that turns me off. So in that regard, yeah, it's great. And also, we also get two other characters. Well, there are a few other side characters, but two in particular, Set Hearth and the Huntress. Set Hearth, at the when we first meet him, or when Zana first meets him, going under the assumption that he's gonna become her new apprentice. But then later on, this Huntress character, who was a part of the Sarah storyline, actually becomes the new apprentice. Which, honestly, yeah. And, you know, more female characters, that's always nice. Yeah, honestly, there isn't really much to say about this one compared to the other two. I mean, the other two had continuity fuck-ups that pissed me off to no end, but this one is honestly solid. When it comes to original stuff that doesn't involve adapting other, or when Karma Jean isn't trying to directly connect with another person's work, I think he's fantastic. You know, with the previous two books trying to connect to Jedi vs. Sith and Bane of the Sith and fucking up the continuity severely. But here, no, it's its own original thing and it works out really well. Again, it's going to be really interesting going to the Revan novel, given that, you know, Karma Jean didn't have any, or they didn't really have any involvement with KOTOR 2. So see how the Revan novel fucks up that. And lastly, I wish we got more stories set after this, because, you know, with Zana and Huntress, or Darth Cognis is her Sith name, we don't. I mean, I think we could have gotten, like, I think this could have been a whole line of novels just going through, you know, each master and apprentice, you know, up until we get the Darth Plague, up until we get to Darth Plagueis. But oh well, that's something we could get if the EU is ever continued. But at the very least, this story is done. It was wrapped up nicely. Bane is a really good character, in my opinion. This trilogy did a really great job at fleshing this character out when all we had initially was Jedi vs. Sith and Bane of the Sith. And continuity fuck-ups aside, I would recommend this trilogy to anyone either getting into the EU or just wanting to see more stories involving the Sith. And when it, like, yeah, even if you're into the new canon, I would highly recommend this trilogy. Now, I guess this is a good segue into when we do eventually get more Darth Bane, or when we do eventually get Darth Bane stories in the new canon, what do I want them to take from, the Bane trilogy, Jedi versus Sith, Bane of the Sith? Honestly, preferably, I would want them to do something completely different. I've said this before, but I want the new canon to differentiate itself from the EU as much as humanly possible. Because we've seen before when they try to do EU characters, it doesn't work out well. Or when they try to keep these EU characters close to their original incarnations while also trying to do their own thing, it just doesn't really work. Or Quinlan Vos is a good example where we have these two different versions of Vos, the new canon Vos clearly being heavily inspired by EU Vos, but also doing its own thing that's in every sense of the word inferior to what we got. But that's whatever. If they are going to take anything from the EU, I would just say keep his backstory, because that's like really important. Keep Zana as his apprentice, and then just from there do your own thing. Because even though we got a trilogy, like between Dynasty of Evil, Rule of Two, is a 10-year time jump, or at the very least, after we get past the Battle of Rusan, we jump ahead 10 years in Rule of Two. And then between Rule of Two and, no, Path of Destruction, I meant. And Rule of Two to Dynasty of Evil is another 10 years. So we have 2 decades worth of stuff that happened we don't see. But still. So, yeah, this video is definitely much shorter than the previous two reviews, but I mean, honestly, that's just because there isn't really much to say. It's a good story, wraps up the trilogy pretty well, wraps up Bane really nicely, sets things up for potential stories, but not necessary or not needed. We don't need future stories, it just would have been, well, nice. So, yeah, that's that. Wraps up the. This is the end of the Bane trilogy. So, what did you all think? Did you all think this was a proper conclusion to not only Bane's story, but also the trilogy? Would you have wanted more stories set after this with Zana, Darth Cognis, and then, getting new Sith Lords as the series progresses up until we get Darth Plagueis? Let me know in the comment section below. Until next time, this is Captain Henson signing off.